Ní mhór inis bhí figurí na Monarchan seo a thuiste tá na gré abrínaí ag fullsin tan coma ar gohfuil brabas níos tehairtaí ná an buil sleinte agus bethe na hebrannaí seo, agus an dearcú an na muon sin ná bhfuil an rialtas ag genú a dhéth ná go leor le déile le seo. Tá na sé instance of COVID-19 are regrettably on the rise. The situation in Dublin is profound, and no doubt we'll have the opportunity to discuss this further throughout the course of the day. Underpinning our response in dealing with the virus must be proper testing and tracing system. And we of Sinn Féin have been raising this issue consistently because it is central to how we handle the situation. Another issue that we've been raising is the issue of meat plants, and I want to raise it with you again here today, Minister. Meat plants have been the site of at least 44 clusters throughout the state, at least 1,600 cases of COVID-19, and they were the principal reason for the localised lockdowns in Kildare and Laois and Offaly. According to a Freedom of Information response to Hannah Quinn Mulligan of the Irish Farmers Journal, we now know that there were 226 cases associated with one plant back in July. We understand that that plant was in Cork and that the plant was never closed down. 226 positive cases. Yet last week, testing in meat plants was suspended. Yesterday, we learned of another outbreak in a meat plant in Waterford, and this is causing huge concern at this point in time. At least 28 cases are associated with this cluster. More tests are pending, and hopefully the HSE's infection control team are on the ground, and you may let me know if that is the case. Local media in Waterford have reported that earlier this week, workers from the plant were being bused to work on board a packed 50-seater bus. Every seat full, standing room only, people standing in the aisles. And at that time, there were already cases confirmed in that plant. Now, that is shocking, Taoiseach. The meat barons are playing with people's lives in the interests of profit, plain and simple. And they're getting away with it. And why? What hold does the meat barons have over Fine Gael and Fianna Fáil? Contrast what they're doing with the treatment of pubs. There were 6,800 inspections of pubs over one weekend. Yet there have only ever been 5 clusters associated with pubs, according to the figures released last night. Yet outbreaks in meat plants have accounted for 1/3 of all workplace clusters. The situation in Waterford has been going on for a number of weeks now, but it was only confirmed that this was happening yesterday. And that's simply not good enough. This is a situation that's replicated throughout the state. Before he assumed office, the current Taoiseach called for greater transparency where clusters were happening. So I'm asking you, Taoiseach, will you accept that the HSE should now publish the detail of clusters in businesses and public settings? Having to rely on the rumour mill is simply not good enough. Communities deserve clarity, they deserve transparency, they deserve better. So in summary, Taoiseach, can you answer me this? Why are the meat plants getting away with this? Why are workers being crammed into buses? Why was a plant with 226 associated cases not shut down? How many meat plants have had serial testing carried out this week? And will you publish the information of where clusters are in relation to public settings?
Thanks very much, Deputy. Meat plants, as we all know, are at high risk of becoming clusters for inspection. There's lots of reasons for that. But we know that's the case in Ireland, and we know that's the case around the world, and we've known that for a very long time. And that's precisely why there are specific protocols and particular protocols in place in relation to meat plants. It's why there is a joint committee on it. It's also why surveillance testing happens in meat plants. And yes, surveillance testing, even though the positivity rate is very low, it's still done as a precaution, as it is in nursing homes and some other places. And while it was suspended last week when there was a huge increase in demand for testing, it has resumed and resumed last Monday. The decision to close any meat plant, or indeed any business, but the decision to close any meat plant is made by public health officials or by the Health and Safety Authority as appropriate. And if a plant needs to close, well, then it should close. And there is no message, directive, policy, or anything from government saying to our public health officials or to our health and safety authority that plants shouldn't be closed if they need to be closed. And I want to make that very clear. if public health doctors and public health officials dealing with the cluster believe that that place is an outbreak, believes that it should be closed, the government fully supports any decision to close a business or a meat plant or a school or anything else if that's the right thing to do in public health terms. And I hope that's abundantly clear. In terms of details on clusters, I think that the public health authorities, NPHET and HSE, should be as transparent as possible in putting out details of where clusters are. But I think it's important at the same time that we're careful about what we mean by that. You know, a cluster can be two cases. It can be two cases connected. Most clusters are households, in fact. And we need to bear in mind that a cluster stays open until 28 days after there has been no case. So in putting out public information about clusters, we need to do so in a way that doesn't end up stigmatising people or doesn't end up in a situation where individuals or individual households get identified. You know, it's always been the case in Ireland, and I think it's a good thing that your healthcare information is private, and that if you have a particular illness or an infection or a particular type of cancer, you're the only person who should tell other people about that. It shouldn't be put on a government website. So we need to be careful when it comes to that information and how it is disclosed. What I can say is that this week we passed a very important milestone. 1 million COVID tests have now been carried out in this country. And I want to express my thanks to all of our health service staff and our laboratory staff for making that possible. Contrary to what you may hear elsewhere, the amount of testing we're doing is reasonably high on a per capita basis, higher than countries like Germany, which is held up as an example to follow, higher than countries like New Zealand, which is often held up as an example to follow, higher than Sweden, for example, which others from a different perspective say is an example to follow. And I think that should be recognised for what it is. And I want to express my thanks to our health service staff and the laboratories for making that possible.
Look, for years and during your tenure as Taoiseach, you told us that we had the capacity for 100,000 tests. Last week, we carried out 72,000 tests, yet you suspension of testing in meat plants was happening. Now, the concern we have here is we have to be based on evidence. Evidence tells us that 4 out of 10 workplace settings, or nearly 4 out of 10 workplace clusters, are happening in meat plants. It is having a devastating consequences to the local economy, to communities, and the people of Kildare, Laois and Offaly will tell you exactly what the impacts of that can be. We now have a situation where we're told that the government is alert to this issue, that the government is carrying out all the proper surveillance, as you mentioned. Yet you have a situation where a meat plant with a positive case is busing workers in a 52-seater bus where every seat is filled and people are standing in the aisles. Now, how is that going on, Taoiseach? How is that being allowed to happen? How is the fact that the most serious area where clusters are developing in workplace was the area where testing was actually suspended? So can I ask you, what steps are you going to make sure that these workers are protected, to make sure that there is a robust process in relation to meat plants? Because time and time again, I believe, and the people believe, that there is some grip that the meat barons obviously have on Fine Gael and Fianna Fáil in relation to your response on this issue.
Thanks. Thanks very much, Deputy. I don't have any details on that particular cluster, nor the means by which the staff get to work. But I will make some inquiries and get back to you later on, if possible. Deputy, you can spin out as many conspiracy theories as you like. The message is very clear. If the public health officials or the Health and Safety Authority recommend or order a business to close, well, then it should close. Full stop. And you can create any kind of paranoid conspiracy theory you like, but I can guarantee you that there is no message, nudge, direction or policy from government to say to any public health official that they somehow should treat meat factories with kid gloves. That's just a paranoid fantasy from your party. Deputy, you're a clever person who you know numbers. You said there have been very few clusters and outbreaks in pubs. Sure, of course there hasn't. They're closed, with the exception of those operating as restaurants. Finally, in relation to capacity, we have capacity to do 100,000 tests per week, not per day, as your leader said yesterday. Got our facts wrong once again. 100 divided by 7 is about 14,000. Can we do 14,000 a day? Yes. Are there days in which we've done 14,000 tests a day? Yes, there have in the last 2 weeks. Have there been occasions when demand exceeded 14,000 one day? Yes, that has happened. And that's what required the suspension.
That's why you suspended the test last week. Because you didn't have the capacity.
Could we have just a little respect for the chair, please? Just a little. Thank you. If you could stick to the questions, please, and the replies.